by the end of the first film, she's, I mean, it will take time to fully resolve all of her hurts with her father, but, you know, the first steps have been made and a lot of forgiveness has happened, and she's in a really good place. And so it was exciting to have the chance to go back to this character and play her in a new space, in a space that was not so guarded and jaded and cold, but was warmer and more at ease in her own skin. I'm not an avid film or TV watcher, and so a lot of the times I haven't seen a lot of the greats at work, and I don't really know what kind of presence I'm in until I'm in it. So I went into it just like, great, Michael Douglas, yay! And then I actually started working with him, and the very first day that I worked with him, I remember immediately when they called action and he started to perform, it was like he changed the chemistry of the molecules in the air. I mean, just the whole room changed, and I felt immediately transported into this world of Hank Pym and Hope Van Dyne. I somehow wound up with Michelle Pfeiffer and Michael Douglas playing my parents, and both being equally as incredible and consummate and lovely and competent and talented. And again, I mean, how can you be bad working with Michelle? How can you be bad working with Michael? So if I am bad, it's all on me. It's my fault. I did it. I screwed up because they're so good. And I'm so happy that I get to act with them. Where we pick up with the second film, they were doing the kissy thing for a little while. And they were in a committed relationship. They loved each other. And then Scott ran off to Germany and had a costume party on a tarmac and decided that he didn't care if that affected our lives or if that ruined our life. And as a result, he got himself arrested. And since that point, we have no longer been an item. The Wasp costume that you saw at the end of the first film was an old prototype from the 1980s. So people have been chattering online saying, wait a minute, the costume we're seeing Evangeline wearing, it looks totally different. And of course it does, because technology has evolved, and I'm a woman of 2017, not 1987. And I updated the suit with my father. We made a new one based on the prototype that fit Hope's needs for this day and age. And I did 4 months of fittings to get that suit perfect. And you know, the one thing I told the costumer when we started was, I don't care how long it takes, I don't care how long I have to be in this room with you, we will make this suit perfect.